A few minutes ago, we showed you how to make a fascinator. Now we'll show you how to make a derby hat for next to nothing. Crafty McGee is here, Elizabeth McGee. She's going to show us how to put together a hat when you decide what colors you want to wear.
That's right.
Anybody can do this. And you bought a $2 hat at Target.
Yes.
A sun hat.
And so nobody would really know that once you spruce it up with all these decorative elements. And all of these items cost less than $25 at the craft store.
Okay. So we start with ribbon.
Yes, and so with the ribbon, you're gonna create the band around the hat.
Okay.
And I make sure the seams are in the front of the hat because then you can cover it up with your other decorative elements.
So glue here, or glue on the hat, doesn't matter?
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
Just be careful about the hot glue gun.
Right. I'm notorious. Do I do it? Here's another question. Do I do it flat or do I pull it around and glue it down to this part of
the hat? It's kind of in a V.
Okay,
and
so I need to glue it down on this part of the hat.
Yeah, and that way it straightens
it out. I tried to do this
out.
Before and I had difficulty and I couldn't get the ribbon straight, but I was trying to glue it this way, you know, straight around. So we're going to make a V. All right, that's good to know. So put another little dot of glue there and I'll get my ribbon. All right, so now that it's almost on there, right? There we go.
And then this is just netting. You see these in veils a lot.
Mm-hmm. So
birdcage
veils. A bow just by looping it.
Then I'm using a bread tie.
This is what you get off a loaf of bread. So when you're done with the Wonder Bread, you just use a twist. So I glue that here?
Yes. Okay. Some people use floral wire, but not a lot of people have that. Yeah.
Right. No, you don't have to go buy yourself a whole spool of it. All right.
And then this is just a flower and some more of that ribbon to match the band.
Do you need to go heavy on the hot glue? This is my concern when I've made hats.
You don't want to go too heavy because then it'll take forever to dry. And then also don't try to put this hat on while the glue's still drying. You might glue it to your head from the other side.
Oh, that's no good.
I've done that before.
Oh no, you glued a hat to your head?
It wasn't too bad.
All right, so then we press this here. We're just going to hold it and give it time to dry.
Yes.
Then you'll be able to wear the hat. I've always worried about things falling off if I assemble my own hat, but hot glue should really
do the trick. The hot glue pretty much holds it. And the good thing about hot glue is you can always fix it if it doesn't hold.
And then you say we can always go back in and add simple things like single. This is what I did to my hat last year. I had a hot pink hat. The ribbon was already woven as part of the hat. And I had a yellow dress.
Yeah.
And someone had suggested that I add just 3 tiny little yellow feathers, and that really is what it needed.
Yeah.
So you could tuck these back in, or you can use the hot glue if you just want to add another little extra touch. And I've got to show you the hat that Elizabeth's already done, because I thought it was really creative. You see a little bit of everything at the track, and so if you wanted to have a theme, maybe a cardinal theme, look at the one she's made, just with the little sticky foam letters. She's got her L1C4 on there, little basketball, black and red ribbon. You can get creative, but still, this can be done for under $20.
That's right.
Okay. And do you have any advice on deciding what to put on the hat? You know, how big is too big?
It's really up to you. Okay. You want to sort of balance it with your face. You know, if you have a small face, you don't want your hat to be too big.
Huge.
Because that's the only thing people will see.
Right.
So you want to kind of balance it out. I like one flower, some ribbon, some feathers, and some netting.
But think layers, and that's what makes it interesting.
Yes.
Don't try to do 6 flowers.
No.
Gotcha. All right, well, here it is. And Elizabeth also has a blog, Crafty McGee. We have a link on our website to her blog, so you can find out more about how to make a hat or some of her other craft projects. That's not bad, really. That's the best I've ever done, that's for sure. Thanks for your guidance on that.
Thank you.